He says, JP, come to the premiere of my new movie. Then I went down, he said, I have a surprise for you, and he didn't tell me what it was, but when I watched the movie, I saw the surprise.
How did you go about finding Patron?
Patron started back in end of 1988, beginning of 1989. I had this fellow who was a friend of mine named Martin Crowley go down to Mexico. Martin had gone bankrupt. He was in the hospitality business, so I staked him. And we went to the architectural business, furniture architectural business together. I said, Martin, why don't you go down on your next trip to Mexico? Because we were drinking some tequila at that time. But you had to hold your breath, that type of tequila. I said, why don't you go to Mexico, see what the aristocrats drink, bring back a couple bottles. He went down there shopping for stuff and then came back with a couple of these just trim, you know, ordinary bottles, but it was pretty smooth tequila, smooth than anything I ever had. And Martin said, JP, I met a guy down there named Francisco Alcaraz. He's like the chef of all chefs of tequila. He said he can make this smoother. I said, really? He goes, yeah. I said, if he can make it smoother, let's try going into the business. I'll order 1,000 cases, which is 12,000 bottles. And we found this beautiful bottle that we would make out of recycled glass, which is a Patron bottle today. And we would make it out of recycled glass. And hey, it was expensive. If it didn't sell, well, for the next 10 years, everybody I knew we'd have gifts for, because it's the best there is, with great pride. Okay, JP, let's try it. Nobody would take us on at first. No one would distribute it because it was $37 a bottle, where the normal tequila then was $4 or $5 a bottle, most expensive 14 or 15. So we finally talked a wine company that only sold wine into taking it. And they did a couple thousand cases a year, and that didn't do too good. So we took on another distributor, Jim Beam, a big one. And they would distribute for us to everybody. Jim Beam came to us one day when we said, guys, we gotta sell 30, 40, 50,000 cases. They said, boys, let's tell you like it is. You have the best tequila in the world, but it's too expensive. That's why we only have 12,000 in sales in cases nationwide. Guys, you'll never do more than 20,000 cases. We dropped them, took on Seagram's. Seagram's took us to 70,000 cases and did a good job, I must say. We got into a lawsuit with them and we had to pay them some money, but we got our distribution back. And the company that was never supposed to do more than 20,000 cases a year, this year I think we do about 3,300,000 cases with all the brands of Patron that we have.
Okay, here's what I don't get though. So you try this tequila that you know your buddy brings back. You like it. He knows somebody else who could make it smoother.
Met this guy, yeah.
And so off of that, you decide let's.
I tasted it, was great. I figured this is going to take off like wildfire because the world is ready for high-end tequila. We didn't have them at that time, no premium tequilas. And I was just setting the world on fire. Plus, when I would go out and pitch it, I would make sales. Right. For example, Wolfgang Puck, friend of mine, Wolf, JP, this is really good. Will you carry it? Of course, JP, I'll carry it. And give it to, and here's some extra cases, give it to your celebrity friends. Martin went to the Baja Cantina. I went going bar to bar. And for $2-3, I'd buy someone a shot of tequila. You could do that in California at the time, right? And then I'd break out Patron, give them a little bit of it. They go, what is this? That's the future of tequila. So a lot of it was done door-to-door sales that we started. And then I did a big Paul Mitchell event once, brought everybody to a game, all free Patron. They loved it, went home and asked for it.
How did actor Clint Eastwood impact Patron?
Well, Clint was a friend of mine, and I would, you know, give him Patron tequila. He really liked it. He said, JP, this is pretty good stuff. And then one day he calls me up, and this is 1991, maybe 92. It's after I'd started Patron. He says, JP, come to the premiere of my new movie. Then I went down, he said, I have a surprise for you, and he didn't tell me what it was, but when I watched the movie, I saw the surprise. All he did was drink Patron tequila in there. That was the only thing he drank. And it was obvious as can be. It was just a surprise. He's just a real good guy, wanted to do something nice for a friend. And then shortly after he wrote this major article where he was asked, you know, what do you drink? And he said, fine red wine and a little Patron tequila. He's a good guy. I still send Clint every year Patron tequila, all of our new ones. I take care of the tequila. He's a good guy. He's a good man.
So the price point was $37 when it first came out. Yeah. Next highest was $14. Average was $4 or $5, as you said, for tequila then. So what's the reaction of people that you're pitching to buy Patron at the time, given the price
point? Once they tasted it, they didn't have to hold their breath. They could sip it. They didn't have to make it disappear in a margarita, even though it's a very good margarita, okay? They knew that this was high end. If they put some Patron with ice, drinking it neat, it's like any experience, and it's not like any experience they've had. It's like, wow, this is really good stuff. It's more of a connoisseur. And then they, if, unless they drank, you know, way too much, they didn't get the same hangover the next day they were normally used to. And it was like, wow, this is pretty cool stuff. What quality? We are ready to treat ourselves. And people started treating themselves, which meant that they got whatever nice little buzz they wanted, maybe drank a little less, and were more conscientious. Instead of putting the shots away, they were more conscientious and delicate on the way they drank.